this time has left the hockey game in the first period.
The latest casualty just loses an edge and goes face first into the boards, and you see his neck snap back and just played over a minute and pointing to his shoulder a little bit there too, but tough to guess on what the problem could be. All we know is he's left the game, and some more bad luck for the Montreal Canadiens.
Awkwardness here of Adam McQuaid. He leans and he's expecting something up top. Richards moves. All his weight is at the top on that miss, and once his legs get caught up, I mean, he goes crashing into those boards. No chance for him to protect himself.
Well, his chin hit the dasher, and that's just ugly geometry. Hit from behind, and as we've told you many times, the Department of Player Safety doesn't go back after someone suggests it. They watch every frame of every game live. They tag every situation. They read the referees' reports.
Watch, the numbers are there. Quick check, and Callahan just continued through with the hit. And I wouldn't be surprised, Jim, if this ends up being a major.
I would be shocked if it's not five. I'm right with you, Craig.
So far, the referees haven't even huddled to talk about it. They're standing over Chris Letang after that hit.
Boy, already as advertised, though, the speed of this game and the turnovers at one end end up with chances at the other.
Well, see, there it doesn't look quite as late. Gaberlet passes, and then he's watching his pass. Oh, you know what I? Oh, you know what happened there, Doc? He hits Thomas, and then Thomas goes flying into the boards, and it might have been the contact with the boards that caused as many problems as the hit itself. And that's just a unfortunate situation here.
His turn, and it's just in, and it's in hard. And you see, he worried. He's going to get five in a game for that. The back is turned. Watch right there. The back's turned.
And Ken Lowe out.
That's ugly.
And you just hope it's not as bad as it looks.
And again, Clark MacArthur, it's the old story. He doesn't play that way. He's a very useful player. He's a tremendous checker, played in the 05 World Junior for Team Canada, maybe the best World Junior Team Canada ever had. And he's not that kind of player. That being said, sometimes good people can do bad things. There's a good person doing a bad thing.
They get the shoot in, okay. Holtby looks to shoot it himself out over the line, and he got some help. Got it as far as the line, then it was cleared by Jay Beagle. But it nearly backfired on the goalie.
He gets nudged by Carlson here. Oh boy, head first into the boards again. Continued on the shift. And I'm not sure when Holtby followed through, he probably tripped him up a little bit also.
Only 47 seconds left on the clock.
The penalty on Dion Phaneuf on this hit right here. How is that not a penalty? This should be even strength.
He actually loads up.
But they want to call Seidenberg for a hit to the head earlier in the period.
Yeah, Phaneuf's gone.
Not before he tries to have a conversation with Chara.
Well, Chara can speak six languages. I got a feeling I know which one this one is. It's the same one Gordie Howe used to speak.
Well, Phaneuf's not going to the box.
That's amazing.
It is amazing.
That's amazing. That's a legal hit, folks. That's a legal hit in the game of hockey.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
And they're trying to get injuries out of the game.
It's you know, don't waste your breath.
You have to get him into his hits on his pads. That's right on the numbers by Thompson. He drove so much smaller, goes in heavily, awkwardly, easy call to make. And the Calgary Flames, who need something to cling to in this game, now go to the power play with an opportunity, get one back, and start what they hope will be a comeback.
Is punched wide by Cedric Paquette, and a big hit in the corner as Camper's down, and we've got a battle brewing there. Dumont involved along with Paquette. Edmund trying to get in there as the officials trying to sort things out, and the gloves are perhaps coming off from Kreider and Paquette, but the linesman quell that one, and it's Dumont who's coming out and heading to the box for the Lightning.
Well, Kempfer was in against the wall. Watch number 43, the original collision against the wall. And then he goes into the corner here, and he gets hit by Dumont, and that's what draws the original
eye. Was up trying to help him. See Pouliot bump him there. It's not a vicious play by Pouliot, but it's the end result that is awful. Here's the play as both players are battling. Talbot initiates some of the contact, and then Pouliot hits him from behind there, and you can see what happens. Oh. That's why hitting from behind is something we don't need.
You gotta just ride him off.
Pelly's on the play. 5 minutes for boarding, and a game misconduct.
And a game misconduct, so that's a 10th injury. But when you take a look at that play again, and that happened right to my right of me, and that just made me cringe because he hit with such a force, guys. It was scary right off the bat that you knew that he was not going to be well coming off that. But let's take a look.
Creates this opportunity with a great little outside-inside move. The rebound, he fans, and oh, man. Goes headfirst into the boards. He makes a great move here on Carl Gunnarsson to get the scoring opportunity. And then gets tangled up with Jake Allen and the defender Colton Parayko. And then goes headfirst into the boards right there.
So medical attention now. The team doctor has come out. 6:07 left here in the second period.
Pardon me, John Moore. And now here's Travis Zajac in on the right wing. Knocked to the boards. Wow. Face first, and he's down. They'll blow play down. There's no arm in the air. But Zajac hasn't moved a whole lot after the period. He went face first in the boards. And now Chaput, who threw the
push,
didn't see who grabbed him.
I was looking at Travis Zajac too, who's still down.
And he's been cut. You can see maybe the nose the way he went in, but Chaput not a fan favorite here in New Jersey after Travis Zajac was sent into the boards and injured.
Chaput just shoves with one hand, and you can see Zajac can't get up to protect himself, and his face goes into the top of the dash.
The board. Watch Trouba come back. He gets shoved hard from behind, and he does go in face first. He's aware that Brown is there. He uses the net, but Brown gets a little bit inside. I don't think Trouba expected him to come on that angle quite as much.
And right in the numbers.
Yeah.
So Mike Brown will head to the penalty box, and Rob Millette checks Jacob Trouba out at the bench, and the Winnipeg Jets will get their third power play opportunity of the hockey game.